Hello, beautiful humans, and welcome back. So today I am at Kilo Kitchen in Bali, and I just finished creating a super simple and easy Twitter AI agent that is basically trained to look for the top breaking news in whatever your industry might be. For me, it's trained on looking for AI news, but for you, it could be real estate or sports or celebrity news or cryptocurrency or whatever it is that you're interested in. And you can decide how frequently you want this agent to be posted on Twitter on your behalf. And so I'm going to show you what this automation looks like, and then I'm going to show you step by step exactly how you can set it up for yourself, your business, or your brand. So let's dive into it. So this here on my screen is exactly what the automation looks like. And so we're using a tool called N8N, and N8N is one of the best automation tools on the market. When I first got into automation, I was using make.com, which is a little bit more user-friendly, and I think the visual design is just a lot cleaner. But N8N is definitely one of the most powerful ones on the market, and make.com no longer supports Twitter's API integration. So if you're looking to build a Twitter agent, it needs to be through N8N. So let me walk you through step by step how it goes. So this is what your automation is going to look like, and what I've gone ahead and done is I'm going to be giving you guys a downloadable file where you can literally just plug and play this automation into your N8N workspace. So the first thing you're going to do is log in to n8n.io, and it looks like this, and you click sign in. So once you sign in and you create an account, you're going to go to open instance. What you're going to do is you're going to create a new workflow, and it's going to open a new canvas that looks like this. You're going to click import from file. I'm going to give you guys the downloadable JSON file, and it's going to be available on academy.geteducated.ai. So I click JSON, and then here's the Twitter automation. I click open, and it actually opens the workflow into your N8N workspace. And so when you click on the first module, which is actually the trigger, this is what triggers the automation to run. And so because it's set on a schedule trigger, what that means is that you can choose how frequently that it is programmed to run. So right now I have it set for every 6 hours, but to be honest, for Twitter, it's one of those platforms where you can post 5-10 times a day and the algorithm only rewards you. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set it to every 4 hours. Okay, I'm gonna click back to Canvas. And so the next thing that we have to do is the search query is basically what you are searching. So here I have, what is the latest news in artificial intelligence? If you are in real estate or crypto or some other industry, all you have to do is change the query. So rather than artificial intelligence, I would write real estate, you know, or whatever it is that you're into. But for now, I'm going to keep it as artificial intelligence. Here is where you're going to set your API keys. So this is actually going to be extracting data from Perplexity.ai. And if you've never heard of Perplexity, it's kind of like ChatGPT. It's another LLM, but some people prefer Perplexity, or they prefer Claude, or they prefer ChatGPT. So what you're going to do is you're going to go over to Perplexity.ai. And once you sign up for an account, on the left-hand side, you can go to accounts, and then on the left over here, you'll see API keys. So you just click API keys, and all you have to do is click create a new key, and it's going to create a key that looks like this on the screen. It's just a chain of different numbers and alphabets. And this is the API key, which helps you integrate different apps together. So all you have to do is copy this API key, go back into N8N, and you're gonna paste it right into here. So I've already done that, so that's all good to go. So the next step that you have to do is connect your Twitter API to your N8N, and this is what's gonna give it permission to take that news, write it up in Perplexity, and then put it into your Twitter without you having to manually post it. Now, this is the part that would get a little bit complicated, but all you have to do is go to your credentials and create a new credential. Now, I already have mine created. What you have to do for Twitter is get your client ID and your client secret. And so let's go back over to developers.x.com. and you'd have to create a new account under your Twitter developer and then go into the developer portal. Under developer portal, you're going to go to projects and apps, and you're going to do is you're going to create a new app. Now, I've already created mine and it only lets you create one. So once you've created your app here, you can click on it and then go to keys and tokens. And then right here is where you'll find your client ID. And right here is where you'll find your client secret. So I've already created mine, but what you would do is you can click regenerate. It'll give you another key of alphabets and numbers, and you copy and paste these two into your N8N. Right here, client ID, client secret, and you would click save. And so what we're gonna do now is we're just going to click test workflow, and you'll see here, workflow executed successfully. So what I'm gonna do now is go into my Twitter, and I'm gonna see what it is that it posted. Here we go. 11 seconds ago, OpenAI removes promotional videos for Johnny Ive dealt amid trademark dispute over AI-powered devices concept. So what it did was it just looked for the breaking news on AI and it created a tweet for me. This is what it did yesterday. And so if you want to edit the style of the tweet or anything like that, here when we go into Perplexity, this is actually the directions that we're giving it. So under the parameters, it's saying to it, you are a social media assistant summarizing tech news from Twitter. Only return one article. Your output must follow this exact format, which is maximum 140 characters followed by a single space. It's saying do not use markdowns, hashtag emojis, or line breaks. But I actually like those, so I'm going to delete this part. Or you can say use emojis, use line breaks, or use whatever it is that you want to train it. This is the part where you're going to give it new information. This is super cool because depending on how you want to train your AI agent, it can be trained in your brand, in your voice, in your style. You can tell it to use emojis, you can tell it to use hashtags, whatever it is that you want. And when you start to run this bot again and again and again, you will start to see growth on your Twitter account, and you can position yourself as an authority in that domain. It is literally that simple, and just like that, you have a Twitter AI agent that posts for you on autopilot. I really hope that you guys test it out and let me know what you think. If you ever need help or support, I'm always here in the community. You can talk to me directly. Best of luck on building out your Twitter agent. Thank you again for joining me, and I can't wait to see you on the next video.